I can't, sorry, even I'm annoyed with myself.
Hi guys, my name is Grace Helbig. If you don't know, now you know, your life is different now. It is the end of March. Here are some things that I enjoyed this month. And like every monthly favorites video, here's the caveat. I may have included some and or all of these things in a previous favorites video, but that does not change the fact that I enjoy it very much. This!
Can you see ya? Can you see ya? Can you see?
This is a candle that I got from Target. It's the brand White Barn, which I have no idea about. White Barn is probably going to eventually be my stripper name. It's in the scent Bergamot Mint. I don't know what bergamot is, but this smells so good, and this burned so slowly. This is like a really bad UTI. It burned really slowly, which is great for a candle. And it smells like bergamot mint, I guess. I don't know. What's bergamot? Let's learn together. Now this is edutainment. Hey, orange. It's an orange? Oh, it's a fragrant citrus. Oh, see, I always thought it was a wood. Classic first world problem confusion. Yeah, this does smell citrusy and minty. And I like that the outside looks like this like marble thing that's very trendy and everyone likes. It makes me feel really Pinterest. Cute! Next! This!
Can't see it!
Can't see it!
Can't see it!
This is a plant thing, home decor item. It's a really cute little geometric plant holder with an air plant in it that's actually alive. But the best part is it's got magnets on the back, so it goes on your refrigerator or any other sort of magnetized surface. So it makes my refrigerator look cute as fuck. My refrigerator is kind of ugly as fuck. No offense, refrigerator. Thank you for your service. The insides don't match the outsides. But now they kind of do. This looks moist right now because I watered it right before this video because I realized it's kind of dying, which is impossible to do with an air plant. Don't let anyone tell you you can't do things. I'm killing an air plant. This was like $3 or $4. I got it at Lowe's. Cute. I like it.
Next! This!
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
Can you see it? Man, this favorites video really shows my age. Whew. So far I've favorited an air plant, a candle, and now some glass cleaning wipes. I'm fun. These are Windex wipes. If any of you give a shit about cleaning windows or mirrors or any sort of glass-like surface, these are fucking awesome. I'm a wipe person, aka I'm a lazy piece of shit. Cleaning for me, if it's very easy, I will do it. And this makes cleaning glass and windows super easy. I use Clorox wipes on every surface of my house, but I can't use them on windows. But now I can use these. Cute! Next! This!
Can't see it!
Can't see it!
Can't see it!
This is a makeup product. I feel like there's something f***ed up with my eyes. Is it just that they're extraordinarily tired? Guys, I played hard this weekend and I did not work hard and I'm a little sad about it, so bear with me. Oh my god. I'm fun. I truly don't know if I've had this in a favorites video in the past, but I've been meaning to put it in a favorites video. It's called Lip Chic. And basically it's this clear liquid that you paint onto your lips on top of your lipstick, and it keeps your lipstick from smudging off. It basically turns any lipstick into a lip stain, and I love it. I never wear lipstick because I'm a awful woman. I'm a nasty woman. I smudge my lipstick constantly, so I only wear lip stains, but I have a bunch of lipstick colors that I really like, and so I found this on Amazon, I think because Candy Johnson had mentioned it or a product similar to this, and I've been loving it. It works really well. I have a lipstick on right now with this on top of it. It does sting a little bit, but I love Sting. He's a very sexy musician. And it's slightly drying, but it's not as drying as a lot of other lip stains, so I think it's great. Next!
This!
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
Can you see it? If you watched my recreating Taylor Swift's Coachella look, you know what this is. This is a foundation, Bronx Colors Pump Up Brush Foundation, and I used it in that video for my foundation, and I just really like this a lot. One, because you don't have to dirty a beauty blender or a sponge or anything. It's all right in here. You basically push this button and then the foundation comes out the top and you just suit this all over your face. You just literally paint the white barn. It's not very translucent, but it also doesn't feel like you're wearing a shit ton of makeup. The technical term for caking your face, wearing a shit ton of makeup. And that's it. I like it. Cute.
Next.
This.
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
This is a skirt that I bought from Zara, but it's got shorts underneath. You got pranked so hard. You should feel so embarrassed right now. You got pranked so hard. Oh, I got you so good. I'm calling this a sneaky skirt because it's not a skort. A skort, you can see like the shorts in the back, which I don't necessarily love. This just has sneaky shorts built in underneath, which is fantastic and makes me so much more comfortable wearing this. Also, I realized that I love this color yellow. think I will be wearing much of it this spring and summer. And it was pretty inexpensive. So it's at Zara right now. Next! This! Can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it? This is my laptop. But I'm not favoriting the laptop. I'm favoring this laptop case that I got from Amazon. I've always seen a lot of people with laptop cases and I've always thought, really? Is that necessary? And then I realized how dirty my hands are and how gross my laptop looks when I pull it out on planes and how embarrassed I feel by the association of me being just a nasty woman. So I got a case, which I think this is like $10 or something relatively cheap. Feels really nice. It's got this like matte plastic finish that it feels good, and you can tell because it's still dirty f-ing fingerprints all over it. Why are my hands so dirty? My hands get really dirty because I always touch my face and my foundation, and then when I touch things, it, you know. At least if I like murder someone, I will never ever get away with it. So that's a cute human trait. But I really like it because it makes my computer look like cute. If people see this, they're like, that girl has her shit together. And then I open my laptop to how dirty it is, and they're like, oh, wow, I got pranked so hard. She definitely does not. Next, this! Can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it? This is a tiny backpack, also from Zara. I love backpacks. I carry backpacks all the time now. I like having two hands free because I'm a clumsy person, and so there's a possibility I could fall at any moment, and it's better for me to have two hands to brace myself. Also, they're just convenient. It was pretty inexpensive, and the best part is all of the straps are totally adjustable, so you can take them off completely and carry it like a purse, or you can adjust them so it's like a crossbody or whatever, and it's cute. It's got a little pocket in the front, and it's got all that. It's very 90s, but upgraded? Next! Can you see it? Can you see it? Can you see it? Can't see it, but you can see it. Yes, of course you can, but you can definitely hear it. Todrick Hall, amazing YouTuber extraordinaire, has an album called Straight Out of Oz, if you haven't heard it already. It's so good, and I've recently been so obsessed with the entire album. He just released a couple music videos, one with RuPaul and one with Bob the Drag Queen. I love both of those human beings, and they're such great music videos, and the songs are so great. The whole concept album is incredible. It's basically about the Wizard of Oz, but mapped over like his life and like current society and all these like very interesting, relevant themes, but still completely inspired by the story of the Wizard of Oz. I highly recommend you guys go check it out. Plus, Todrick's one of the most inspiring YouTubers. He works his ass off. He's so talented. I couldn't be more of a fan. If you watch some of the music videos from Straight Outta Oz, you might see a certain try hard. Let me know if you find me. Thank you, Todrick, for giving me new music that I can binge so hard on. Okay, that's it for this favorites video. Let me know what you guys have been loving this month. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. I make videos Monday, Wednesday, Friday, sometimes. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up so I know. And I'll see you another time in the future. I don't know. You think Waldo wore that hat? Weared that hat? Weared that hat. Oh, hell big. Whew, you have had a weekend. I was gonna say, do you think Waldo wore that hat so frequently because he never washed his hair? Where's Waldo? Not in the shower.